reports, Julian Descendes joins us today with a story. Julian, what prompted this emergency work?
Hi, Natasha. Two words: wind power. For the past few years, the United States has become a leader in generating electricity through wind power. You can see giant windmills all over Texas and Oklahoma. And a lot of those blades are manufactured in Juarez. The problem is that the blades are so large, some of them are 150 feet long and longer, that it takes a lot of effort just to get one across the border.
So, Julian, what does the state of transportation, what does it plan to do to accommodate these blades?
Well, I was out there today, and I was told they will be widening the roads coming out of the commercial inspection booths. This will keep the trucks carrying the blades from blocking traffic for up to half an hour at a time. However, I was told that this is only a temporary fix to a greater problem. The fact is that trade and traffic are growing so much at Santa Teresa that the entire port needs to be reconstructed.
And that sounds so expensive. Any idea of how much this could cost and when it could be done?
Well, the cost would obviously run into the millions of dollars. I'm told that a study has already been, the proposal for a study has already been submitted to the House Appropriation Committee. Santa Teresa business leaders hope the study is approved because it will attract even more industry to southern New Mexico and far west Juarez. And this will have a major impact on the state of New Mexico if approved.
All right, Julian, thank you for sharing that story. And you can read Julian's full report on borderreport.com.
All the news across Texas.